Hello, my friends, and welcome back to another exciting episode of Hunting Rocks. As always, I am your hunting guide, Jeff. I am back in Illinois. It's July 30th. By the time you see this, it'll probably be November something or another. But anyhow, I'm out at my geode spot, and I'm looking for geodes. And I've already found one. But before I get into that, let me show you what my spot looks like in the summertime. You can see the geode hunting is going to be a little more difficult. But not too difficult, because I found this one as soon as I came down here. It does rattle. I don't know if you can hear it, but that is a nice hollow geode, and that's going in my bag. I'm gonna keep looking through here. We've had some good rains. We've had some dry spells, and we'll see what, if anything, besides that one, we can find today. That's not a geode. Alright, down in my favorite creek for geodes. There's one. There's a little one. That's not one. That's a geode. That's definitely a geode. It's harder to find them now, though, because usually I'm here in the fall and the grass isn't this tall. Well, grass and weeds, but three geodes right off the bat. Four geodes. Here's another one. Can't beat that with a stick. Alright, here's a geode here. This one is pretty solid, but it's still kind of pretty inside. Come on, focus in. There we go. Now, these are more of your true geode as opposed to the Dugway style. These are they're inside of dolomite limestone. They do get much bigger than this. I just haven't found a big one in quite a while. I have pulled them out of here, about the size of a watermelon. My great-grandma, way back in the day, she pulled out a massive one. That's a pretty geode. That'll be nice once it's cut open. But as you can see, like I said, these are the limestone dolomite outer shell, whereas your Dugway geode is a rhyolite shell, so it's more along the lines of a thunder egg up there in the Dugway geode bed area. Down here, that's just a pretty piece of chert. Down here we have more of the true geode. These are same formation as your Keokuk geodes. They're just a little bit further down. You run into the same stuff whenever you get down to like Kentucky. Down into the Kentucky geodes and whatnot. So they're pretty much all the same. The insides can be a little different due to, you know, whatever minerals were floating around at the time. These are mostly quartz, mostly milky quartz. I do get clear ones out of here occasionally, but I'm gonna go check my other area here in a minute. But I just want to explain some of the geodes to you. Well, I walk around and look for them, because I know there's a bunch down here. Here we go, guys. Here's a much larger geode. They do get bigger than that, but that is a nice one. A little bit of a rattle. I'm hoping it's hollow inside. Oh, what a shame, you guys. I just found this. This one is broken, but that would have been a beautiful geode. I think I'm going to take this. I should be able to clean that up. A little iron out. No, I'm not. It's home to a little water bug. Those little water bugs eat mosquitoes. Yours truly hates mosquitoes. So that'll go back in the creek. I'm going to have to make my way up and around there, because that water gets deep and it's dark. It's dirty, and I really don't want to get my toes bit off by a snapping turtle. So I'm going to check this shoreline here real quick, and I'm going to make my way up and around that and down over there. But before I do, I just pulled this out of the mud. That's another nice sized geode. It's got a rattle to it, and a little bitty guy right there. All right. Now we're getting into some good-sized geodes today. A bunch of them are finally washing back up to the surface. Well, guys, I made it. Whenever I walked through the jungle and came down, I was greeted by a beautiful broken geode. Look at the sparkle in there. And not only that, with some little tadpoles, which are somewhere in here. I guess they're hiding under rocks. Well, I'm not going to search in this area because there's tadpoles in there. Let them grow up to be big old frogs. This area here is a little more gravelly, a little less grown over. It's a piece of coral. That's pretty cool. So, let's see what's washed up over here. Just found another nice broken geode. Look at that one. Somebody, well, maybe somebody busted it. Whatever happened, it stayed there. Here's another nice one. A bunch of broken ones up through here. Let's, I know some of you are like, why are you throwing those away? It's all right, I'll find better ones. That's not a geode. Let's walk up this way. Oh, that water feels nice and cool. I just had a herd of deer walk up on me. There's one. Oops, sorry, I lost them. That was my bad, guys. All right, well, before I surprised the deer and they surprised me, I walked over here and I saw this little geode laying right down there. But then I looked over and that wasn't done naturally. Somebody left a bunch of geodes just chilling. I'm getting a better sunlight for those. That's 2, 4, 6, 8 geodes that they left. Not a geode. Ah, do I want those geodes or should I leave them for someone else? You know what? I'm going to take 4 of them and leave another 4 for someone else. So, there we go. I'll take these 4. Those 4 belong to someone else. Alright, I've seen a bunch of geodes over here. That was a nice one. It's all busted up though. But, well, there's another busted one. There's a decent one. Right there. Got a little bit of a rattle to it. Here's another one. That one's got a crack out of it, but pretty sure it's hollow. It's super light. And I know I'm missing them. That's a flat one. A little bit of a rattle. That'll be cool cut open. Not a geode. Check down near the water here. What do we got here? What is this? Not a geode, but that's a geode. Nice little rattle to it. Whenever I say rattle, I shake them near my ear. You can hear the stuff that's loose inside of them rattle around, which guarantees that they are hollow. That's a geode. I don't know if you can hear it. It does have that rattle to it. I love this place. I fill my bag pretty quick. Never run out of geodes yet. In fact, there's new ones down here all the time. One of these days, I'm gonna figure out where they're coming from. Nice rattler, little bitty guy, but pretty solid, and not a geode. I'm gonna figure out where they're coming from. Talk to the person, whoever owns that land. This isn't owned by anyone where I'm at. And, tell you what, they can make a fortune selling geodes by the bucket full. Not many people in this area realize that there's people like me who would pay to go look for geodes. Don't get me wrong, I like my free spots, but most people around here are farmers and they think they're just dealing with rocks. There's a nice family of little geodes. Right here. Not very big. Ooh, that might be the tiniest geode I found out here yet. Let's take a look. No, no, that's not a geode. But these are. That's a little bitty guy. I like the little bitty ones. They cut pretty quick on my saw. My bag is starting to get a little heavy. And I am sweating like a sinner on Sunday out here. It's funny, it is Sunday. There's a nice rattler. Yeah. That one is for sure hollow and will look good inside. Well, I say it'll look good inside. If I'm lucky, it'll be clear. If I'm lucky, it'll be clear quartz. If not, oh, that's a nice hollow one. Heck yeah. Hopefully that one's a clear quartz. That's a nut. I'm hunting rocks, not hunting vegetation. Listen to that one. Hear that? That's the geode rattling. There's a couple more. This is the area I've gone to and shot the video where I haven't paused it and just went straight through looking. So you guys know this area is just filthy with them. But I tell you what, I'm starting to sweat like crazy. The backpack is getting super heavy. It's like 98 degrees outside today. I've got my drink back at the truck, which isn't very far from me. So I think I'm just going to look for a couple more minutes. Oh. Nope, nope. And I might get back to the truck pretty soon here and show you guys what I found, unless I find some really cool stuff between now and then. All right, you guys, it's time for me to head back to the truck. As you can see, this is the more gross side of hunting rocks in the summertime. I am sweating like crazy out here. It's not terribly hot, it's just incredibly humid. And sweat keeps dripping on the camera and messing things up. Sorry about that, probably TMI. But I want you guys to know, you know, if you're gonna go out and you're gonna hunt rocks, you gotta know what's up. I, of course, have some water with me. Well, I had water with me, I drank it all. That's the other reason why I'm heading back to the truck, because I have more beverage there. And staying hydrated is key. Here in the Midwest, it's still very important. Not nearly as important out in, say, the deserts of Arizona or Utah, but don't let it fool you. If you're in a humid area, you still need to carry water with you, because you will dehydrate very quickly out here. Like I said, I drank my bottle of water. Hold on a second, I see a geode. Nope, nope, that one's been busted open, I'll leave it. But anywho, that's enough safety talk, I guess. Let's get back to the truck. I'll show you guys what I have. I've got my large ones today. My medium large. My mediums. My rather small ones. My small ones. And my itty bitty teeny tiny baby ones. I'm going to cut some of these up. I'm not going to cut all of them up, but I am going to cut some of these up and show you guys what they look like inside. Some of them I may crack if I can get my hands on a cracker. With these type of geodes, it's better to crack than it is to cut. You can cut them okay, but the way they form inside, if you cut them, you can cut through some really nice stuff. Now, like your dugway geodes, those you got to cut, and you got to be careful about it. You want to make sure you just cut through the outer layer. These, cutting them, they cut so fast and so quick that cracking them is the best way to go. Anywho, I'm headed home, but first I'm going to get in the air-conditioned truck and cool off. So I will see you guys back in St. Louis, which should be right about now. All right, I cut this geode open in real time. Let's see how it looks. Meh. Pretty lame. But it shakes. Hold on. Let me try something. There we go. There's some crystals out of it. I just didn't cut in deep enough. Well guys, Hamilton and I hope you enjoyed the video today. We hope we can get a like, share, and subscribe. Yes, I love you too, buddy. Mwah. But anyhow, as always, we'll see you guys the next time we're out hunting rocks. Have a good one. Bye. Say bye, Hamilton.